So yesterday, I had to censor myself for the first time in a very, very, very long time. And it didn't feel good. And like I knew that some people wouldn't like my opinion. There might be backlash, people angry about my opinion, which happens if you're going to, you know, go into commentary or share an opinion whatsoever of any value whatsoever. That's part of the gig. But just a few minutes after I was uploading the first version of yesterday's show, I got the word, if you include this, it's very likely going to die. Whole video, your effort, everyone's effort. So because I'm a dick that likes to have my cake and eat it too, I cut it out of yesterday's show, but I'm posting it here. So yeah, here we go with me from yesterday with slightly longer hair.
This is a new show.
So maybe this is a controversial thing to say out loud in public to a lot of people, but I kind of just want to throw it out there. So this morning, I see the headline, Mila Kunis opened up about disagreeing with Ashton Kutcher over her parenting choices after she encouraged her 6-year-old daughter to push another child. And clickbaity BuzzFeed headline aside, right, they kept out the fact in the headline that her daughter was pushed first, right? Mila Kunis was saying, stand up for yourself. And from that article, right, there was this debate of, is that right? Is that wrong? Is Mila right? Is Ashton right? You know, my opinion on this is I would love if all problems were solved by us using our words and teacher forced apologies. And, you know, we want our kids to say stop and get a teacher, but sometimes a bully just needs their shit rocked. They hit, green light, you hit. One of the many problems we have in this world is that there are far more people that know how to create problems and stop problems. And that's what I tell my children. That's what I tell my boys. You do not start a fight. You do not start a problem, but you are okay to end one. The unfortunate truth is that left to their own devices, most bullies won't stop. They just get older. And shittily enough, a lot of aspects of our society end up rewarding them for being the worst version of themselves. And understand, I say this knowing not everyone's gonna be on my side here. Someone this morning responded to me kind of forming this idea on Twitter and said, shocked you'd be the one to say it, Phil. Don't teach your kids to fight other kids. Shouldn't be on them. I'd almost rather you'd beat up a kid who bullies than this. Like, Adam, did you get dropped on your head? You want me to go to the school and, like, what, start karate kicking second graders? That wasn't the pushback and advice I was expecting, but I want to make clear. Obviously, there's an order to these things. Not every situation is as escalated or the same. Like, don't start just throwing bows wildly. Like, try, yes, to use your words first. Is it a situation where you can walk away or there's a teacher to help? But if not, you got to defend yourself. Otherwise, I think not giving our kid that option, it just teaches them to get walked on, and the world for the rest of their life will be happy to do so.
And damn it, I stand by those words. I'll see you later on today's full Philip DeFranco show.